gas leak sent people running for the exits of the Pottawatomie Bingo Casino this morning.
This is a live picture we're going to take from News Chopper 12 this evening. It was a huge contrast from the evacuation of hundreds of people from earlier today. We have live team coverage of this leak and the evacuation. 12 News' Nick Bohr is live outside the casino. And are things back to normal at this point tonight, Nick?
Well, they are now, Toya, but people were certainly left out in the cold literally about 10:30 this morning. They were hustled out here in the middle of their slot machines, blackjack tables, and bingo games. Most didn't even have time to grab their money when they heard gas leak. They just tried to get out as quickly as they could. For some, that wasn't very quick.
The patrons of Pottawatomie Casino are used to people shouting, "Bingo," not "Gas leak, get out."
Gas leak, everybody got evacuated. So everybody moved. Everybody left everything and moved.
They couldn't stop moving until they were blocks away and cut off from their cars. All they could do is wait. For some, it got pretty chilly.
I'll put you in there. Then you can go get warm, okay?
So shuttle buses came in, taking the mostly elderly patrons a few blocks to the Pottawatomie Administration Building.
I was playing a slot machine, and all of a sudden they ran through and said, "Hey, everybody out, gas leak." They ushered us out and ushered us out, right out. Left the money in the machines and everything.
They eventually learned what happened. A construction crew severed a 6-inch gas line leading into the casino.
They did detect a smell. Actually, there was. It was noticeable. And so I think that probably on some level also helped to make sure that people understood that this was something that they really needed to evacuate the facility.
Not far in time or space from the Falk blast less than a year ago that killed three people in the Menominee Valley, certainly no one wanted to take any chances. We Energy's crews had to go through the casino complex room by room and check to make sure none of the gas had pooled, leaving the possibility of a deadly explosion.
Everything's under investigation yet, so you don't know. Gas lines do get hit from time to time. Hopefully if there was a location of the lines, but we'll look at all the investigation, all the factors having to do with this particular hit.
And 2.5 hours later, the patrons were let back in, and things got back to normal. And as is often the case, some folks will try to look at the bright side of even the most worrisome situations.
Well, I was out here, so if I was in there, I probably would have lost more.
Well, some people did leave cash in the machines and on the tables, but the casino says they have systems in place here to make sure that people were reunited with their money. Live at Pottawatomie, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
And Nick, there are a number of restaurants inside there. I assume they use gas. Are they going to be back open tonight?
Right. They got the gas turned back on here about 3:30. We're told the restaurants opened back up about a half hour ago.
All right. Thanks a lot, Nick. Yeah.